Hey, horse people. I'm gonna show you what Mr. T looks like. Good boy, Mr. T. Looks like he's got a little right there. Maybe that mange is coming through. His little tail. You're okay, Mr. T. I'll stay back here and just zoom in. You're okay. So I put some of that MTG, which is basically a sulfur compound, and Buddy doesn't have any of the symptoms at all. It's mainly Mr. T's tail and his mane. If I can zoom in on that mane. And so first I put that new stock, because I had some of that new stock, and that's a sulfur compound. And the more I read about it, sulfur seems to be the big thing to keep the flies away. He was already wormed, so I don't think it's worms. So I did his legs, and he doesn't really have any under his chin, but I did notice his ears today is also kind of getting it, and I don't know if you can see it. And again, Buddy has no symptoms whatsoever. Younger, healthier immune system. Mr. T's getting old. So I got some of this, poor Mr. T. I know. I got some of this tea tree shampoo. Now, I'm not a big shampoo guy. I usually don't use shampoo on my horses. I rinse them with water. I rinse their salt off. And I don't use shampoo. But because they're having all these issues, well, not they, Mr. T. Hang on, I left the shampoo in the house. So, when I went in a feed store looking at, oh, now Buddy's scratching. He probably just got bit by a fly. So this stuff right here, the feed store said, they have a lot of people that say this is pretty good. And there was a vet tech in there, and she says she uses that on a lot of the animals. It has pretty good. And I want to say it was about, I don't know, 18, 20 bucks for this bottle. So they're going to get some tea shampoo. Mr. T's going to get it first because I really want it to sit and soak in on him. Getting a whole bunch of salt off him. Sorry, buddy. But that thing on the side right there, I just noticed. It looks like there's a couple spots on his legs, which is more leading to mange or mites or flies than internally, because it was internally. I don't think he'd have it on his legs and on the side. Now he could, I'm sure there's gonna be somebody out there. Oh no, he can get it anywhere. But hang on, Miss Terry, I'll throw the hose over you. I know. So, getting a little salt. Again, I don't see a whole bunch on his neck. His little ears were kind of I'm just going to wet you down so you can be cool. Dad's not going to give you a bath. He's just going to cool you off. Woo! Right on the back leg.
Woo! Dad, that's cold. It feels good.
So, Buddy's just going to get a little damp so the air cools him off. And then... And then I'll shampoo him, but I'm going to shampoo Mr. T first, because I want that tea stuff to sit on him a little bit longer. And he seems like he's kind of enjoying this nice cool, I don't know, it's 85 out here, it might be 90. Rubbing his neck. Let me get your face a little bit wet there, buddy, because we're going to soak that up too.
I know.
I know. So, I,
Oh, look at those eyes.
Oh, goodness.
So I haven't seen him rubbing his butt, but he was rubbing his shoulder. Somebody's gonna probably tell me I should put this in some sort of bucket. Here's a tip, you gotta remove that before it'll come out. Stupid barn witch snuck that in on me. So we'll soap him up with this tea stuff. And he's gonna smell all fluffy. But like I said, I normally don't use any shampoo on these guys, so they're gonna think this is pretty foreign. Like, why are you putting this smelly stuff on me? Sorry, Mr. D. Those damn pink panty girls out there told me to put something that smelled good on you. And now I did it. And now I'm a mean, bad dad. I know.
No, goodness.
So I'm gonna try to keep it out of his little eyes, nose there. Get him good and soaked up. I just saw a fly in his ear. That's gonna be hard to rinse off. I wanna get it good on any mange spots, but especially on his tail and neck. And I'm sure if I put some of this in a bucket and had a cloth, I would use less. But I want this semi-concentrated so it'll do good. So I'm really gonna soap up that tail really good.
Oh, no, poor Mr. T.
And I know a lot of people were saying, one guy wanted to collect money, give me money to call a vet. Look, I got no problem calling a vet and spending money if my horse needs it. But my experience with vets is they're going to come out, they're going to do a bunch of tests and go, well, it could be this, it could be that. Why don't we try this for a while? Why don't we try this? I'll come back in 2 weeks and we'll try this. And I'm not really, if it was something serious, I wouldn't be anti to that type of treatment. But like I said to some people online, his demeanor, his appetite, and none of that is changing. So if none of that's changing, I'm treating this as more of a not that serious. Now the reason why it's probably as bad as it is because my first thought was worms, and I treated wormer, pinworms, and I washed it with betadine. And people were like, you should wash it a lot with betadine. I only washed it twice. I washed it when I wormed them, and then I washed it a few days later. So, and I didn't see any infection or swelling or oozing or pussing. So I was like, let's try that. And after I tried that, it didn't look like it was getting any better. I know, poor Mr. T. And then I made this video, and mange tends to be under the jaw, under the legs, around the tail. So those are the areas that I want to concentrate now that I'm treating the mange and the mites. And now I'm going to start putting medicine like that MTG. I already put that new stock, which is another sulfur base. And the MTG has oil in it. It's mainly mineral oil and sulfur. So the sulfur keeps bugs, gnats, chiggers, and stuff away because they don't like the sulfur. The oil will keep it moist so it won't crack and dry out. And supposedly that MTG promotes hair growth. So we'll see how that goes. But
I figured I would go ahead and give him a little bath in this tea, whatever, tree. I might have to wet you down a little, Mr. T. You're not sudsing up. You're not sudsing up, buddy. I gotta get you some more water. No, not the water! Yep, we gotta suds you up, Mr. T. So I can get some sudsing action on these legs. I got pretty good sudsing action on the tail, but all his water has dripped out of him, and I'm not getting good suds. And this tea stuff doesn't smell too bad. Hell, I don't know what it smells like. But I'll get all this on him. I'm not gonna put any of that MGT on tonight. I'm just gonna rinse him off and let him go roll. It's about 6 o'clock, so the sun's going down. And the flies and stuff will be going down. So once I get him suds up, hopefully this stuff will, if you remember a year or so ago, they had these little crusties right at the back of their feet, and I was trying everything to get rid of those, and they have it a little bit now, not near as bad as it was, but there is a little bit of crusties back there. And for mange, they were saying those little mites and stuff like to hang out around swampy pond area. So I got that pond back there. So maybe that's contributing. And again, I think a lot of horse care is trial and error. There's not a lot of fixes. I know there's people out there, call a vet at the drop of the hat. I just think that's a lot of wasted money. And you're not really getting what I consider what you're paying for, because a lot of horse care is trial and error. My philosophy with horses is it's gonna get better or it's gonna get worse. And if it gets worse, then I call a vet. But if I can manage it, you barely got any little fur locks. You were rubbing that off too, boy. Then I will manage it. Sorry, Mr. T, I grabbed your tail. You see that little flinch? Because I didn't pair him. I didn't come here and go to his tail. I just went straight to his tail and he went, oh, what was that? So that was my fault. So I got a lot of this tree oil, tea tree, all over him. And another thing they say good for fungus, and I need to add this to my website, was the stuff you use on a sheath. Whatever the sheath cleaner is with that menthol, I usually use that caliber, I think is what it's called. They say that's good for any fungus also, so you don't have to just use it on a sheath. Sorry, Mr. T. You can use that anytime you get a little fungus there. So if they get that stuff on their feet this time, I'm going to use that on there. Alright, so Mr. T has got this good tree stuff all over. Somebody on there said Mr. T's losing his hair everywhere. Big old bald patch. I'm like, are you kidding me? What the hell's wrong with these people? I swear I don't know who puts these people's pants on half the time. Now I'll get Buddy good and wet so I can soak him down. like his face. He's not as good as his face with Mr. T. He gives me a little bit more of a hassle. So you're going to see him act like a big baby here. I don't want to get all the hate mail about how I'm squirting him in the face and how bad it is. I'm squirting him in the face, he'll get over it. But he don't like it, and he don't take it like Mr. T. So it's going to look like I'm being mean. Tough.
I know. Oh, I know. Dad's so mean.
Oh, my goodness, it's so horrible. I know, it's so horrible. I know. Dad's just a big...
I always rub their eyes because that water and salt gets in there, so I try to rub their eye and get that moisture and water out. And then I'll go back to the rest of them. And he's going to pout the rest of the time out here because I squirted him.
Dad's a big beanie!
I swear. You got more damn fan club out there, people hollering at me for being mean to you. Hang on, Mr. T, I'm sliding this over you. I know.
Rick, you should never do. You could cause him the truck. He could pull and break his. You tie your horse too long. You should never put a hose over. You shouldn't squirt a horse.
Shut up, you big dummies. Tell him, buddy. Bunch of dummies. So Buddy's got a little salt on him, and I gave him a bath the other day. Oh, you know what? I didn't give him a bath because he was swimming in a pond. So that's why I'm seeing this more white, creamy milk coming off him because it's all the salt. Mr. T, I got most of his salt off. But Buddy, I didn't. So I'm like, wow, why's he got so much more salt than Mr. T? Because I didn't hose him off the other day. He went in the pond. I'm going to squirt your butt. Cold. Everybody's gonna yell at me. I know. I know. Everybody's gonna be yelling at Dad for being mean to Buddy. I swear. You people, you're always yelling at me, Buddy, because I'm too mean to you. They treat you like a little powder puff. Dad don't want you turning into no sissy. Want your own bathroom and shit, and then I'll be like, what the hell? This might be the first time I use shampoo. I might have used it on it before at a barn because somebody else said, try this, it's really good. But normally, I'm a straight water guy. And I know somebody's out there,
see, that's why he's got mange. If you be using...
Shut up! It ain't why he got mange. He's old and the bugs are out and different reasons for that. It's not... I guess it could be neglect, but my guys are pretty well taken care of. And... See, he's got a little more crusties than Mr. T, and he usually does get more crusties. And I was reading, and I don't know if it's true, that light-skinned or tan, not dark horses have more of a problem with those crusties on the ankles than darker horses. And when they get those, Buddy always gets it worse than Mr. T. And some people will say it's all BS, because there's another little crazy thing out there. People say white hooves are not as tough as dark hooves. And I'm always hearing people say that. People, oh, I'm Uncle Ferrier. And they said it's true. I don't think that shit's true. The color of the hoof happens to be related to the color of the horse. And that's what it is. However, Buddy gets those little rough thingies more than Mr. T. And they say feathers on your draft horses, like Mr. T, have more of a problem with mange and stuff because or rain rot or any of that crap, because they have more hair, and hair keeps moisture, and moisture allows bacteria and fungus to grow. So I'm not promoting trimming your horses, but if it was a problem and your horse had long feathers, trimming them is not going to hurt them. I do not like trimming horses so they can cool down and you can run them in the winter and then they're freeze and you got to put a blanket on them and they can't stay warm. I definitely don't like that. But and now the way the wind's blowing out here, you may not be able to hear a damn word I'm saying. That's all right. Say thanks, Dad. I'm listening. Are you listening, buddy? If those mean old YouTubies ain't. Oh, goodness. Now, because horses' smell is more sensitive, you put shampoo and stinky stuff on them, and I can almost guarantee you they're going to want to go roll quicker and more to get this stinky stuff off. But this tea tree stuff should hopefully be some sort of natural treatment and might keep the bugs off. I can't remember if I did this leg or not. Looks like I did. Buddy! So, well, you know what? I need to get Buddy's tail. Although he's not having a problem, and I don't like messing with something if it ain't broken. So, I would normally not mess with his tail because it ain't a problem. But since I'm doing this, and since he's packing that tail tight like he don't want me to do it, I'm gonna go ahead and do it. Woo! Buddy's a good boy! Raise that tail! Woo! Oh my goodness. Alright. So because Buddy ain't having a problem, I'm gonna rinse him first. And then I'm gonna rinse Mr. T. Because that'll give Mr. T more time. Get, I mean, he's gonna get some residual. I got his butt and tail pretty good, and to be honest, I'm usually, if you use soap, you gotta rinse really well. I don't like leaving on a horse because it gets dry and it causes problems. But since this is a tea tree shampoo, leaving a little bit may not be the worst thing in the world. Put a lot on his mane. So normally I would rinse them really, really well, but because this is supposedly like some medicated tea tree kind of stuff, I'm doing a lighter rinse.
Buddy, that's a big old soapy mess. He's big old soapy. Crazy, crazy horsey.
All right, let's get the part that he hates. Here comes the hate mail. I see people typing right now.
That's me.
Shut up.
Drink?
No? Alright. I know. sudsy and soapy.
I know. Hang on.
So I'm closing this ear and covering it, because that's the worst thing. Horses don't like things in their ear. So, buddy's pretty much rinsed. I'm going to go ahead and let him go run around and roll and do his thing. Good boy, I know.
I know, it's so bad. Woo! He smells like a little lemon tree.
Or whatever that tree is, tree oil. All right, Mr. T, it's your turn. He's like, where'd Buddy go? So again, I'm rinsing where I put a lot of shampoo around his mane and tail, but the rest of his body, I'm doing a light rinse. So save all the hate mail that I've always told you to rinse your horse good, and save it that I'm going to cause some sort of infection, and I'm making it worse, and I'm a horrible owner, and my horse is to be taken away, whatever. Says they've had pretty good luck with this shampoo. So I am doing multiple treatments. I'm slacking off his grain. I'm getting away from that sugar and equine senior and oats. I'm going to pull that for his internal. I put him on some probiotics. I added some probiotics to help his gut develop good bacteria. They've already been wormed. I'm putting some of this tea tree oil on it. Sorry, Mr. T. Let me get this over. And so probiotics, diet, internal. Now I'm hopefully washing off with this tea tree. And then in the morning, I'm gonna put some of that MDT sulfur and oil on it. I may do it tonight. I don't know. Watch your little head, Miss Kim. Get close to those ears. I know. I know. But we gotta get Mr. T's face. Drop your head. Hey. Head. I know. It's horrible. I know. You're being worse than Buddy. I told him Buddy was bad. You're being a little bad horsey. Drink that water. Get all that. All right, I got to get the ears a little bit because I got his mane. So I'm going between the ears so he can tuck his ears himself. Get this side of his face good. All right, let's see. Let me rub those eyes for you. Again, rubbing those eyes. It's that water so he doesn't have to blink and get all that out so he can open his eyes to see. Makes him feel more comfortable. Horses don't like being able to see or not being able to hear. Makes them nervous. Me, on the other hand, when I'm around barn witches, I like not seeing and not hearing. Makes me calmer. So, that's it for the guys go roll, shake, rattle and roll. I don't know how long this video was.
Hopefully it's still filming. I'll let them in there. They think they're going to get some grain, but they're not.
Hang on, I'll open your gate. I had to close the gate because Mr. T was running in there to get away. that soft block. And then they'll go out to pasture and roll. And that's their little, so again, I'm attacking this on all levels. Probiotics for their internals promote good gut growth. Good gut growth bacteria will promote their immune system. They've got white salt and the mineral block salt and a mountain something salt rock in their thing. So they have three different types of salt. They've got all this green grass out here. I gave them some other grass. Some of the hay that I've had cut, which is pretty old, it's probably a year and a half, 2 years, so I'm thinking it's not a lot of nutrition, it's good and dry, so it's a good to get them off some of this rich grass. They can eat that older grass that I have in the barn that's dry. Let's see, I'm scrubbing them now with this tea tree shampoo, and then I'm gonna put MTG sulfur and mineral oil mix, and we'll see how that goes. I mean, as long as it's not getting worse. I mean, I just saw a little bit of mange like on his ears that I didn't like, and a little bit on the side of his back. So they're both gonna try and find their best favorite spot to roll. So, okay, there goes Mr. T. And he's not being bad, and I don't care if he's rolling. I'm glad he's rolling. It's going to make him feel good. He wants to get that stinky smell off the water. He'll scratch his belly a little bit before he gets up. Oh, good boy. He's a good old horse. He's old. Shit. He's going to have problems. You people don't realize, you youngsters don't realize when you get older, things start falling apart and you got all kind of things. You're like, holy shit, I never knew this existed. Next thing you know, you're at the doctor and he's like, oh yeah, that's normal. And, oh yeah, that. I'm like, what? Really? Shit. Checking my blood, urine, all kind of crap. So, both these guys are having a good roll right now. Buddy's going to get up and buck. Shake. Buddy! He easily runs off and bucks. I'm surprised he didn't do that today. Mr. T got up. They're both content now. Here comes Buddy. Come, Buddy, Buddy! He easily throws a good old kick. So Mr. T's demeanor's good. He's moving good. He's not lethargic. He's not eating. Those are the things that when I get a vet involved. Things like this, I'm not going to get a vet involved unless I can't. Now, if I do this consistently for a week and I don't see improvement and I see it getting worse, then there'll be a vet out here. So it's not a money. It's not that I don't want to spend the money for a vet. It's I don't want to waste money on a vet, and I don't want a vet coming out here telling me to do the things which I am probably doing right now. Because in horse world, it's not like the vet can go, oh, I know what that is, we'll give him a shot, or we'll give him a peel, or I know what this is, and because you can't get feedback from a horse, so there's always this trial and error. Is it internal, external, parasites, blah, blah. So, anyway, I think Mr. T's taking a pee-pee there. I don't know if he's peeing or not. He looked like he parked out a little bit. He's yawning. Might be a little stressed. I've been spraying him in the face. I had him soaked up, had him tied up. Rubbing his leg a little bit. Maybe that soap's kind of itchy because I didn't rinse him real good. Which, again, I don't think as much as I rinsed him, I didn't leave a whole bunch. And since it's tea tree oil, hopefully it'll do more good than bad. And tomorrow, like I said, you know, if he's looking uncomfortable tomorrow, then I'll bring him in. I'll give him a hose down and just give him a good rinse with just straight clean water. And then put some of that MTG on him. So, alright, I don't know how long this video is, but it's basically how I'm treating him. Everybody wants an update. Everybody thinks I'm neglecting him. I got people hating on me. But he's going to rub all over the mange. Hey, let me get some of that mange, because I'm not sick. So I'll just rub all over you, freaking buddy. Oh, Mr. T told him. Oh, Mr. T told him, get away. I love it when Mr. T corrects his little butt. Yeah! Buddy got his butt corrected. Yeah! Look at him. Because he got corrected, he went in front of Mr. T and slowed down like, you're going to walk behind me. So Buddy wanted to reassure that I'm not going to run off and be a pansy. I'll just get in front of you. And if you want to bite me in a butt, you can, but I'm going to make you walk behind me. All right, so they're going to walk out to their little North 40 and go be horses and maybe roll in dirt again and relax for the night. All right, we'll end that there. Hopefully somebody got something out of this.
Save the hate mail about me being mean to Buddy and all that crap. I don't want to hear that shit. Buddy, better than your good boys.